His Royal Highness the Prince and Her Royal Highness Cyalides have returned.
Ah, you're back. You're looking well, my boy. What's the matter, son? Am I embarrassing you? Just a little show of affection between father and son. It's no big thing.
Your Majesty, I think perhaps you better stop before you crush him.
Ah, Cyalides, I'm glad to see you looking well, too. George, Leon, thank you for seeing the prince home safely.
Yes, of course, sire.
Your Majesty, Commander of the Queen's Knights, George Prime, returning to post, sire.
George, what in the world's gotten into you?
I don't know. I was told to mind my manners.
You never were one to listen to other people's advice, so why start now? But on second thought, though, a little bit of prudence might be in order while you're back in the Imperial capital. More than a few nobles aren't very happy with you, being a newcomer and all.
All right, I'll try to watch it. Wouldn't want to get you in trouble, Your Majesty.
Thanks, George, but I don't think you will have to worry too much about that.
Pardon me, Your Commandership. Shouldn't we...
Ah, yes. You're right. Your mother, I mean Her Majesty, is waiting for you. You should hurry along and see her now.
But Your Majesty,
Sorry, now's not the time. I know what you've all seen, but there's nothing I can do about it right now. Our first priority is to see Her Majesty.
His Royal Highness the Prince and Her Royal Highness Cyalides have returned!
Oh, I've been waiting for you. Don't be shy, now come closer. Let me get a good look at you. Oh, my son. I've been so worried. I can't tell you how relieved I am that you're back and safe. Cyalides, thank you for all you've done. I wasn't quite so worried about the prince, knowing that you would be with him.
No need to thank me. I love my nephew too, you know.
And thank you too, George. I'm grateful that you took on this task, hardly worthy of your talents.
No thanks necessary, Majesty. Protecting the royal family is my sworn duty as one of the Queen's knights.
And you, Leon?
Yes?
You're doing a fine job as the prince's bodyguard. Well done. I'm sure the day will soon come when you'll be promoted to a full-fledged Queen's knight.
But, Your Majesty, I already consider it a great honor, one I hardly deserve, just to be allowed to be His Royal Highness's bodyguard.
It is such a great relief to me to know that the prince is in such good hands. Please continue to take good care of him.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Now then, please report on your visit to Lord Lake. What's the matter? Simply tell me what you witnessed there.
Arstadt.
This is Lord Lake?
One of the most beautiful towns in the Queendom of Felaena? Known for its pristine waters and lush woods? Damn, I heard it was bad. I never imagined it was this bad, though.
Yeah, this is definitely Lord Lake, the town that used to be one of the most beautiful places in the Queendom. At least it used to be.
I thank you for traveling such a great distance. My name is Talgiel. I've been somewhat of a town representative here ever since his lordship passed away. I would love to offer to show you around a bit, but sadly, this town needs no guide. As you can see, there is nothing here but scorched dirt and bleary townsfolk. I'm afraid our residents might be rather impolite to you at times. I do hope you can forgive them. If anyone deserves punishment for this, it's me.
So tragic, to see something so magnificent reduced to this.
What's this?
It's Rovere's mansion. Rovere used to be the lord of this region.
Huh. I've heard that name before. That's right. He and his entire family were executed, weren't they?
Right.
Unbelievable. This is even worse than the rumors.
That used to be a lake. The water was so clear you could even see the fish on the bottom. There were so many ducks and geese, too. And over there, there was a deep forest. We were just kids the last time we were here, so we wanted to go explore it, of course. But just as the prince and I were about to set out, his attendants stopped us. Farid yelled at us later, remember? You're not supposed to let them catch you, he told us.
Yeah, sounds like Farid.
Lord Rovaray said the same thing and laughed. What in the world could have happened here?
Unfortunately, this town has indeed felt Arstot's wrath.
What's that about?
Huh? Is something wrong?
They seem to be panicked about something. Let's go check it out.
Thank you.
prince! Over there! Owls attacking people? Prince, wait!
There he goes, rushing into things again.
Damn.
How strange. I don't think I've ever heard of Ulse attacking people before.
They sure looked awfully hungry.
Are you all right?
Huh? Don't touch me!
Hey, don't disrespect the prince!
So you're the prince, huh? Grandpa said you were coming, but I didn't think you'd have the guts. Don't harm me! How dare the Queen's family even show their faces around here? Who do you think brought all this to Lord Lake anyway? Even those animals, they started attacking people because their forest is gone. They're hungry. Who knows how many people have been killed? And all of it. All of it! It's all the Queen's fault! Ugh.
I see. The people of that town still cling to that dried-up land, living out their pathetic existence.
Arstadt?
Well, I'm afraid all I can say is this. It serves them right.
Your Majesty.
How can I, you ask? How dare you, my own flesh and blood, ask such a question? Those people committed an unpardonable sin, that's why. For generation after generation, the Rovere family of Lord Lake had been our most loyal subjects. That's why for many years I had complete faith in them. That's why I looked upon them with such favor. But on that fateful day 2 years ago, they betrayed me in the worst possible way. They banded together and began a savage uprising, plunging the nation into confusion. They ravaged the East Palace and even stole the Dawn Rune. One of the three runes, the very symbols of the Falainan royal family. Such lawlessness, such treachery, such savage behavior. How could I possibly forgive them? And so I, Arshtot, the Queen of Falena, brought down my judgment and vengeance upon them by the will of Providence. With the power of this, the Sun Rune. see, no matter how much Lord Lake may continue to suffer, they got exactly what they deserved.
With all due respect, Your Majesty, you have every right to be angry. But in Lord Lake, the damage extends to women, children, and the elderly, people who had nothing to do with the uprising.
Silence! Do you dare tell me I was wrong? I do not make mistakes. The Sun Rune always lends its divine protection to the just. My path is the path of righteousness. My will is the will of heaven. To defy me is to defy the sun.
Your Majesty!
Ferret.
Your Majesty, everyone is tired from their long journey. Perhaps we should adjourn for now and let them rest.
Yes, I suppose you're right. I will hear the rest of your report later. For now, you may go and get some rest.